Larry Levine joins us right now, head of Wall Street Prison Consultants. Why that's a business is a conversation for another day, Larry. But I'm going to jail. I'm Bernie Madoff. I've got a 285-pound man that has asked me how I might deal with him. Your advice to me?
Keep your mouth shut. Don't be confrontational. Show a lot of respect. Remember, you just jumped into the system. You don't know nothing about what's going to happen. He's been in the system for a while. He knows the ropes. You need to find some people that you're going to run with while you're in there that you can kind of call your friends. But on the other hand, don't trust anyone. Don't trust Oberfest. Do your time. Don't do someone else's time. Don't get jammed up in the politics or the drama, and you'll get through okay. Now, Bernie's problem is he doesn't have an out date. He's never getting out. And because of that, he's going to be in with people like that who have nothing to lose. So I've heard people say that Butner's the crown jewel of the BOP. Well, I think Bernie's the crown jewel of the BOP. And you're going to have somebody in there trying to take him out. He's going to either leave in a box or a bag real soon.
Now, do you think that they know that? In other words, do you think that the wardens and people running the prison system are aware of what you just said, and as a result, he's going to be kept in isolation to protect him from that?
You can't keep the man in isolation forever because he hasn't done anything. On the other hand, you can't watch him forever. And that warden is probably a little pissed off they even sent him there, because Bernie is going to be a problem for the Bureau of Prisons until the day he dies. He's a target, a big-time target. Now, Butner is a little bit different than other institutions. It's a complex. You have a low FCI, two medium FCIs, and a minimum security
camp. What does FCI mean?
More important, Federal Correctional Institute.
Got it. Okay.
Okay, the lows are dormitory living, the mediums are cell living, and the camp, there's no fence, it's minimum security. But let's jump over to the medical center. I have clients that have been to the medical center, and usually somebody in Madoff's situation, they're probably running him through there for a psychiatric evaluation and a medical evaluation. Butner may not be his final home. We don't know that.
Got it.
I've had clients stay there for 6 weeks, and they moved him on.
Jonathan, you want to get in here?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm sort of curious about how many people have sort of prison life coaches. This is something I'd never heard of before.
There's about half a dozen of us in the country, and there's a few people popping up now that really lack the experience. They're doing a great thing trying to help people, but in my case, I did a 10-year stretch at minimums, lows, mediums, and highs. I know what's going to happen somewhere. I'm not reading it out of a book. I know it off the top of my head.
Larry, what were you convicted for?
Narcotics trafficking, securities fraud, racketeering, obstruction of justice, and machine guns.
Was it Elliot Spitzer that put you in jail by any chance?
No, Elliot wasn't involved in my case. He had
his racketeering was one of his specialties, is why I ask.
Well, I'm federal.
All right, understood. You wouldn't deal with it. No, nothing from the state. I'm
no.
a little bit speechless, but at the same time,
this is one of the scariest little pieces of TV I've ever watched. I mean, what we're hearing about, look, we obviously know life inside the federal prisons can be very tough, and Bernie Madoff is going to have an adjustment, especially the prison he's at. He's not at it, as Larry's right. There are some minimum security prisons where life is actually pretty cushy, where the white-collar defendants usually go, where there aren't fences, the whole bit. He is in an institution where he's going to be in there with rough guys who are going to perhaps teach him a few lessons, and this is scary stuff.
Yeah, real quick, I got a bunch of macro cans on my table here, Larry, and that's for the following reason. I am told from people who know more about what goes on in prisons than I do that cigarettes are no longer the currency of choice if you want to make things happen, that it's mackerel cans.
No more smokes in the feds.
No more smokes.
No more smokes in the feds.
So what's with the cans of mackerel?
Well, you use the mackerel. Actually, they're in pouches now. They don't want to use the cans because people can really do some damage with this can.
Yeah, right. I can beat you.
Well, yeah, you can. That's why they're going to pouches. A pouch of mackerel is worth about $1, so it maintains its value. You can use that to have your shoes shine, your bed made, your area cleaned up, get a haircut. It's a common currency of trade throughout the federal system.
Does that mean
a lot of people don't even eat the mackerel. You just use it as trading value.
There's a Federal Reserve that's being created, monetary policy in the Federal Reserve system. Mackerel supplies going up.
I can see, you know, Ruth Madoff smuggling mackerel in a cake into the prison. Anyway, Larry, thank you very much for your time. You're an interesting personality, I would say, and I feel like I learned, and that's why we called this meeting, so I appreciate that. Contessa.
Glad to be here with you.
Thank you, Larry. Come back. Hopefully not, you know, for not to talk to any of us about anything too specific.